While working on this dissertation, An Indigenous Approach to Healing Sexual Trauma, I received a series of images in dreams and meditations. A story emerged, a story I since learned is found in Aboriginal cultures in Australia, Mayan cultures in Central America, but the version most familiar to our culture in the West is from ancient Greece. The Pleiades are a star system in the Taurus constellation, the sun sign of my birth. Only recently did I look at them close up and notice that they curiously resemble a Christian cross. They are named after Pleione, a sea nymph, and her seven daughters. Her husband was the Titan Atlas, the man condemned to carry the earth on his shoulders for eternity. And while he was occupied doing that, the hunter Orion fell in lust with his wife Pleione. Orion was used to taking whatever he wanted. He knew no boundaries. And he pursued Pleione and her daughters ruthlessly for 7 years. They prayed to Zeus, the god of the sky, for help. And Zeus finally heard their prayers, turning them into white doves and placing them in the sky in the configuration we see today. They were safe for some time until Orion died, when Zeus placed him in the sky such that the arrow of his bow pointed directly at the Pleiades, immortalizing that terrifying chase for all of eternity. I have experienced the terror of Pleione, of feeling like I'm under constant impending attack. I was born into a hotbed of conflict: Jewish, German, Russian, American, Christian, atheist. From a young age, I experienced sexual abuse from a family member. And I grew up in an environment full of conflict as well, in Atlanta, Georgia, where the mayor was always African American and the largest park a Confederate memorial. I learned that conflict was dangerous. And like Atlas, I carried this burden of the abuse for more than 20 years until I found people who could help me heal, where I could safely share my story. Through this dissertation research, I worked with sex offenders so I could better empathize with Orion. And this story showed me that in any act of sexual violence, there are three main roles which may be played by multiple people: the victim role, the offender role, and that invisible, burdened bystander role. Indigenous healing is embodied, and it occurs in community. I am here to release all of these roles from my body with you as witnesses. Thank you for being here. To be in the victim role is to have somebody else's reality projected all over you, so that ultimately you learn to punish and imprison yourself. the bystander role is to be so burdened by the cross you bear that you cannot hear the people around you when they are crying out for your help. You are too busy dealing with your own shit. This dance is about becoming free from the bystander role. The offender role.